Good morning, everyone. Welcome to the Stock Market Morning Prep video for Wednesday, October 8th. Right across the board, Dow Jones took it really on the chin, down 272 points, NASDAQ down 69, S&P down 29, and Russell down $18.34. And Russell has been the leader to the downside, and we just broke some key support. And the other indices that we follow actually brought key support of 50-day moving average. So let's see if we continue to get a big flush here. I want to show you a couple of indicators that we're looking at. We're getting to these extreme levels here, so we need to be careful. If you are short, I'm not saying it can't go down. Obviously, markets can, but just be careful looking for possibly some sort of a bounce here. We have the SPX and the ATR, a good indicator for volatility. We have, as you can see here, when we get to these extremes, we usually get some sort of a bounce. We're getting there now. Not that we can't go into that 20 percentile area, but just keep an eye on things here. Maybe we get, I'd like to see a washout, actually, a real big, another big 250, 300 point down day. And then let's see the market start to move higher again. Remember, October is usually a turnaround month. We do get a lot of volatility in October. And since the markets have literally crept up pretty much all of 2014, you actually can get a nice big turnaround if we get a good flush to the downside. So we had you know, a nice little down day today, yesterday. And then let's see what happens here. But right now we're coming into these extreme readings in the moving average. Now the McCollum Oscillator has not done so as of yet. Let me just get that to you right there. As you can see, the McCollum Oscillator is still showing that we haven't met those targets yet. So that is a little disturbing, but we look at the new highs, new low, you can see that we're coming to these extreme areas. Now we actually dropped on Friday and on Tuesday, and then now we're starting to creep back up again. So this could use a little bit more room to the upside, and as you can see, there is some room, really. There is actually some room that we can move a little bit lower before the markets move higher. So as you can see, getting close. We are at these areas now, but it doesn't mean that another big flush can't happen. We are definitely oversold in these readings. So this is the NASDAQ, this is the NASDAQ 50-day moving average, above the 50-day moving average. So if you see that, and then you look at the NYUD, which is the advanced decline with volume, we're into these over extreme readings here, a negative 225 here. So that's something that I've been watching. Take a look at the stocks above the 50-day moving average. We're there right now on the SPX. So we're looking good for some sort of a bounce. When, no one knows. We've got to obviously just pay attention to what price action is telling us during the course of the day. But we're getting close for a possible bounce. I would like personally to see a big washout today and then look to start getting together a nice buy list. Now, what does that mean? Well, that means that the markets, I think we're going to have some volatility for the next couple of weeks. We have Columbus Day coming up next week, but I do think that we might get some extreme volatility. And then getting closer to the end of the month, we should start looking to kind of taper off the volatility and start looking to possibly move higher again going into the holiday season. Remember, we're in October. And right around the end of October, we start to level off in volatility, and then markets start to pick up to the upside. That does not have to happen. Just keep that in mind. We're up extreme levels of all of 2013 and pretty much all of 2014. So that doesn't have to happen. So just keep that in mind. Don't just go out willy-nilly and just start looking to buy stocks. But that is the trend. Looking at the Trader's Almanac, looking at seasonal trends, October turns to seems to be a turnaround month, obviously, so we'll just take it one step at a time. But I'm still looking for some extreme volatility, possibly another move lower, a big flush, and then start looking to create some sort of a buy list here for stocks that you want to buy in first swing trades. All right, let's take a look at some of the indexes here. Well, the dollar is one of the big culprits. We're going to come into earnings season, so a lot of the multinationals are really going to get hit hard here, and it's probably going to be expected, but just keep an eye on the dollar. We did have a big extreme level. We took it right back the next day, and of course, yesterday we're down a little bit, so I'm still looking for possibly touching up the 20-day, maybe even this a big area here of support, which was resistance, and then, of course, we would reevaluate it, but I'm still looking for some of the commodity-related stocks to bounce. Now, crude oil really took it on the chin. It is in extreme oversold conditions, and it can continue to be oversold like that. So don't just pick a bottom here, but right around that 85-ish area, 86-ish area, you know, we've had crude oil just literally just get decimated since the beginning of June, and it's pretty ripe for a big oversold bounce. So pay attention to the crude oil. If you're trading USO, you can use that as a, an ETF for crude oil if you're not looking to trade the future itself. But keep an eye on that. And also, a lot of the oil stocks and the oil services stocks have been really taking it on the chin lately because of crude oil. So let's keep an eye on that for a nice possible trade. Also, home builders. Home builders have actually starting to stable a little bit. Lumber prices have been moving higher, and the home builders have a decent turnaround time in October as well. Okay, just some trade ideas. And also take a look at now. We have the ES, and as you can see, we are definitely in a clear downtrend channel. We have broken the 50-day moving average. So this is the first downside target, will be this pivotal low here coming in at 1889, 1890. Obviously, around a lot 1900, we'll probably get a pause there, but this will be the good spot for a possible at least pause in the downtrend here that we have. On the hourly chart, you can see that we hit already our target again. I mentioned somewhere around here. I said, look, I'm looking for this 1922. We hit that yet again. And let's see what happens if we get another push down again. 1900 would be your first area, and 1890 would be your second target to the downside. Diamonds really, what can you say, really got decimated yesterday with downside pressure. I'm looking at this area here, this pivotal low, besides that 200 that we're looking at. So the 200 and then this area here in the diamonds, or of course the Dow if you're looking at the Dow. Now, here is the culprit, is the IWM, the Russell 2000. Literally just broke that 108, sliced right through, gap lower, and never saw it again. So now the next really downside target, if you look back, it's really getting to be way back down here now at around 105 and then 103 in these pivotal areas here. So, and it's getting oversold. But again, we had a nice big sell-off, and look at the volume. We didn't have a lot of volume. So it's another reason why, you know, if we get another big gap lower, this could actually have a decent retracement rally and pull all of the other indices higher. So we're getting into some oversold territories. Volume did not confirm the move. So, you know, just keep that in mind. You know, when you're looking to get aggressively short, I would not be looking to get aggressively short. Transport, same thing with the transports. You can see we broke the channel that we've been in for quite some time and finally broke it. So the first area would be this little pivotal low here that we touch and we hit back again. So 143, call it 142-ish, 143 would be your next target. And if we get there, I would suspect that we would probably hold, if not tag that 200, which is not too far away from there. But we did have a lot of volume in that, so that definitely confirmed this index to the downside that we had some major selling pressure. So keep that in mind, guys, when you're looking to trade. Now, me personally, I'm obviously just day trading. I'm not looking to hold anything, look not for any exposure, unless obviously if you're holding options or you have an options play against, it's a little different. You can manage your risk accordingly. But swing trading regular stocks in this environment is really not healthy, especially when you don't know. You wake up, the markets could be down 30 handles. Or up 30 handles if you're short. So just keep that in mind as well. All right, so the Qs are finally starting to break down a little bit. And again, I'm looking for this low here to hit, which would be about 93.88, 94. So just, you know, keep that in mind. Keep everything in perspective. So I'm looking for a little bit of a washout. We're getting there now. Just a quick recap in our oversold readings. Love to see the markets come in a little bit more, and they start to taper off the volatility, and then let's see if we do get that Santa Claus rally that we're looking for, at least a decent retracement move, and then again we will reevaluate it again, because if we do get a big bounce and then we fail, and then we start to move lower, then you could possibly not see that Santa Claus rally. Remember, everybody's anticipating that, so just keep that in mind. Have a great day, everybody. We'll speak to you tomorrow. Take care.